请大家一起同心默祷。
Let's pray in silence.
Amen. 好，奉主耶稣基督圣名，我们继续第二节，这个，灵修真理分享的时间。
In the name of Lord Jesus, we begin our second session of sharing the truth.
在彼得前书四章的第七节到第八节。
In 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 7 to 8.
我们天上的真神，提醒我们，当这个世界，进入到倒数计数这样子的一个阶段的时候。
Here God has reminded us that once the countdown has started for the end of the world,
那么很重要的三件事情。
There will be three things.
第一个是讲到我们在这个物质界当中，我们的物质欲望，必须要有所节制。
How we have to control the desires we have.
好，那么第二个是讲到在我们的灵性生活当中，一定要靠着圣灵来战胜罪性对我们的侵蚀。
And secondly, is to make sure that we can go against our desires.
那我们才能够圣洁，回到天上神的面前，得享永生的安息。
And our sins, so we can be holy and return to God.
那么第三个要来谈到在第八节里面所谈到的彼此相爱。
So the third one is in verse 8, how we have to love one another.
因为彼此相爱，我们就能够遮掩许许多多的罪。
Because love will cover a multitude of sins.
那么我们再来思考，万物的结局真的到了吗？
So let's consider again, is the end of all things near?
我们再来看启示录的一段预言的兑现。
Let's again read Revelations.
请看启示录十三章。
Revelations 13.
启示录十三章，从十六节到十八节的这个经文。
Verse 16 to 18.
那么这段经文里面，我们的神他借着，那么显了异象给老约翰看。
So here, God showed a vision to John. Okay.
将来神的教会，要面临，两个从世界而来的挑战。
How the church will face two challenges from the world.
那么第一个就是十三章第一节所提到的，那么从海中上来的兽。
So the first one is from chapter 13, verse 1, the beast from the sea.
那海是，飘，喷风飘摇不稳定的一个地方。
We know the sea got water, so there are waves and it moves.
所以它，我们现在的解读是说，我们的教会将来会，有一些政治上的压迫存在。
So the interpretation these days is that in the future, there will be political powers against the church.
那我想最明显的应该是中国大陆。
And I think one of the obvious examples now is in China.
因为中国大陆它现在禁止基督教，把所有的学员18岁以下的学员全部集中到一个班级去做宗教教育的教导，不准。
And because in China, they still restrict you, so you cannot gather students under 18 to attend RE.
所以我们在中国大陆，我们教会的宗教教育是断线的。
So that's why religious education cannot be held properly in China.
我们只能够借助家庭祭坛、家庭的聚会。
So we can only use family services to do this.
由父母亲负起责任来教导我们的下一代。
So the parents will have to make sure they teach their youngs.
那么在十一节提到说，又有一株兽是从地中上来的。
And in verse 11, there's another beast that coming out of the earth.
那么是讲到，两种情况。
So there's two situations.
那么第一个就是来自于宗教界的排斥跟压力。
So one is the oppression and influence from other religions.
这个是十一节到十五节的经文，我讲大概的意思了。
So this is roughly from verse 11 to 15.
所以我们真耶稣教会，在二十年前台湾的基督教界认定我们真耶稣教会是异端的教会。
So 20 years ago, there was a time when the other Christian denominations say that TJC in Taiwan is a heresy.
好，那现在透过我们台湾总会的努力跟基督教界沟通，最近这十年，他把我们从异端名单删除，但是把我们列入在极端的名单里面。
So after Taiwan GA explained to them and worked hard on this topic, now they've moved us out of that category, but still label us as a bit extreme.
那这种情形就好像这个《使徒行传》二十八章。
So this is similar to
22节。
To Acts 28 verse
23. 在保罗的时代，当时很多人就跟保罗讲说，你在传讲的这个教门，你们这个教派，是到处被毁谤的啦。
So back then, people are telling Paul that what you are preaching, people are saying that this is not right.
好，那么还有另外一个，从地中上来的怪兽，这个叫做666。
And then there's another beast, 666.
哦，那么是讲到由经济而来的压迫。
So this is pressure from the economy.
圣耶稣教会在经济上没有办法画上等号跟天主教，哦，
so,
没有办法。
For example, TJC cannot compare to the Catholics.
我们总是感觉到我们的经济会有相当的压力存在。
Our financials are simply not as great as this.
好，那我现在跟大家分享这一个666在我们现今的世代当中它是兑现的。
And so there are some people that say this number is special in this world.
圣经记载说，哦，在这个人的右手或者在这个额头上面它都要有一个印记，
so,
哦，有一个记号。
Here says there's a sign on people's hand, forehead that there will be a sign.
那这个记号呢是属兽的名。
And this is of the beast.
它是魔鬼所推动的工作，它是一个兽的数目。
And so this is a number of the beast.
那有这个记号才有办法做买卖。
And only with this, you can buy and sell.
十八节也提到说，如果用人的角度去看，它是什么？它是一个人的智慧的结晶。
And so in verse 18 talks about this is actually coming from wisdom and human understanding.
所以我们可以说，哦，从表面上来看，哦，它好像是人类科技进化所产生的一种结果。
So some people say that this is a result of human knowledge and advancement.
事实上是魔鬼的力量在后面 push 推动这样子的一个工作。
But actually it's the devil that's pushing for such work to be done.
那这个到底是什么呢？
So what is this?
我们电脑帮我把那个图片打出来哈。好，这个是我们现今啊做生意买卖绝对不可缺少的电脑条码制度。
So we know that this is a barcode.
哦，那这个电脑条码制度哈啊，你注意看哈，那个三个箭头哈，那么三个箭头你会发现哈，它的长度都比较长。
So we see that there are a pair of lines that's longer there.
好，这个数字在电脑的解读上它代表的，哦，这个条码在电脑的解读上它代表的都是数字。
So, this barcode can be decoded into numbers.
哦，那前中后线都比较长，这个电脑解读它就是数字的六。
So there's an urban legend that says that this decodes to 666.
所以你随便找一个商品，哦，一定都有这个电脑条码它才有办法做买卖。
So there'll be barcodes on items.
以前我们的生活世界里面，我们可能这个皮夹子拿出来，哇，太多卡片在里面。
So sometimes we take our wallet, there are many plastic cards.
你要身份证。
We have some ID.
你坐车要有这个什么，我们在台湾叫做什么？悠游卡，脑筋还是会断线，那高雄，台北是悠游卡，高雄那个不叫悠游卡，那么叫什么电子卡还是什么的，一卡通啊，哦。
So there'll be different cards for.
我不晓得我们这边坐电车，坐车要不要那个卡片扫描，哈。
We have our AT hop card.
信用卡。
We have our credit card.
那我能够消费，领钱要那个金融卡。
We have our F-POS
card. 出国再来一个 passport.
We also have passports.
很多很多，哈，我们台湾还有健保卡，我不晓得这边有没有啊，哈。生病到医院去刷卡，哦，很少的钱。
And Taiwan there'll be other insurance cards.
好，所以有时候看到某个弟兄，哦，那个皮夹拿出来一看，我说哇，你是大富翁啊，带着几十张卡在身上啊，看不到现金啊，全部都是卡片。
So there'll be some people with a wallet full of cards but no cash.
那这个现在会逐渐淘汰掉，因为新的科技已经产生。
And we know that also technology is replacing all this.
以前在光线的领域上，我们最先进的光线的技术，我们一个名词叫雷射啦， laser.
So we know that there's this laser.
那透过这个雷射，我们可以运用在很多不同的科技的角度上。
And lasers are used in different technologies.
比如说我们在台湾，如果你身体有毛病，它现在有一种雷射名称叫做离子刀啊。
So there's the gamma knife that's used.
离开的离，离子而子的子，离子刀啊。
Yeah, so there is this gamma knife.
那这个不必真的拿刀说哇，把你划得流血了，他用这个光线，就能够进入到你的身体里面，切除你身体某部分的这些不好的细胞。
So it can be non-destructive and target certain cells.
那这个是我们目前在光线的这个整个运用上，我们觉得哇，很先进啊，
And we might think that this is very advanced.
以前说什么 X 光就不错了，现在离子刀都出现了。
So there's all sorts of technology in the past.
那现在呢？现在啊，这个美国有一家公司哈，那么它发明的一种哈，我们在台湾接受到的翻译名词哈，叫激光啊，刺激的激，很激动那个激。
And in America, there's technology related to this light that's highly excited.
如果我没有记错，好像它的英文叫什么 ？Exciting light.
So this excited light.
我们中文就翻译叫激光，好，那这个激光它能够把一组的电脑代码，把这样子的一组电脑代码，透这个激光的运用打到你的手臂，或者打到你的额头。
So then with such excited light, they can brand people.
那现在呢，你手臂上的这一组电脑条码。就是你，等于你。
So then they can in a way put IDs on people directly.
这个就是你的身份证。
So this can be a form of identification.
因为电子化的时代嘛。
Since we're trying to digitize everything.
这个就是你车票的号码。
So it can be used
for your transit. 这个是你的医疗号码。
Or for your medical needs.
这是你的出国的通行号码。
Or a way to replace your passport.
这个是你财务金融的号码。
Or for your financial transactions.
你在警察局里面有没有犯案哈？这个号码一扫，全部都可以呈现出来。
And if you're taken to a police station, they can know who you are.
那这一组电脑代码哦，电脑条码的代号哈，我们这里圣经说它叫做666。666。
And that's why there are urban legends that says, all these barcodes have 666 on it.
可能在当时的时代，其他的数字是没有显现的，只有显示三个六啊。
So,
我是这样想的哈。所以老约翰他就记录叫666，他搞不清楚这是什么东西啊。
So that's why some people say, this is all related to the barcode as a joke.
那我们现在全世界哈，世界银行的这个超级运作的大电脑是坐落在卢森堡这个国家里面。卢森堡。
So a lot of the computers related to finance is in Luxembourg.
它是哈这个三层楼高度相当庞大的一个世界超级运作的超级超级的电脑哈。
So there are these great big computers.
那。我们会发现当这个超级电脑架设之后，他们为这个超级电脑命名。
And when they named these computers,
我们以前曾经听过说，哇，电脑很厉害，跟人类下棋啦，跟什么苏联的什么世界棋王下棋哈，这个棋王被超级电脑打败了，那个超级电脑叫什么名字？叫 Deep Blue。
And so, the computer named Deep Blue can beat people in chess.
那卢森堡这个世界银行运作的超级电脑，他们取的名字叫做 The Beast, B-E-A-S-T, The Beast,
and
就是大怪兽。
The computer, their name, they call it The Beast.
那跟我们的这个什么，跟我们启示录13章里面17节讲到说，这个是兽的名，这个兽也是用 The Beast。
And so this is also the same word as in verse 17, talking about the beast.
神讲的预言都可以完全的兑现。
What God says, the prophecies will come true.
恰巧吗？
Are these coincidences?
名字都那么恰巧，圣经神讲的那么跟人类所命名的一样，恰巧吗？我都不觉得这个是恰巧，这个是预言的兑现。
So for me personally, I believe that this is the prophecies coming true.
所以我们要知道真的世界末日很近了啦，我自己觉得已经很近了啦，不会再太久了。
So for me myself, I feel that the end of the world is very close.
那只是我们不知道那个日期什么时候会到。
It's just that we don't know the time and date when it will arrive.
那在这样子的一个时候，我们的神除了告诉我们要谨慎住守，要警醒祷告之外
，So God tells us to be watchful and pray.
我们的神要告诉我们说，请大家要彼此相爱。
God also tells us to love one another.
那我看到这段经文，我内心又产生了一个问号。
So when I saw this, I had another question in mind.
我们当中彼此相爱，神就赦免我们的罪吗？
If we love one another, well then God forgive our sins.
那是不是说人与人之间的爱本身有除罪的功效性呢？
Then is it that love between each one of us has the way to remove sins?
那应该不是说、哦、我们在生活当中用爱心彼此互相对待，然后神他就会饶恕我们所犯的罪，不是这样子的。
So we know that it is not the case that just because we love one another, God will wash away our sins.
因为罪要得到神的赦免、哦、除了耶稣基督的宝血以外，没有第二个因素。
Because there's no other way for our sins to be washed away other than through the precious blood of Jesus.
这个地方讲的彼此相爱，这个爱到底是一个什么样的爱呢？
So then the love here, talking about loving one another, what kind of love is this?
如果你去看希腊文的原文、哦、这个爱的原文、哦、叫 A-G-A-P-E, 叫 agape.
So in Hebrews, this love here uses agape.、哎、
在希腊文他们描述爱这个原文、哦、可能有三个不同的字眼。
So they use three different words to describe love.、
哦、那么第一种是谈到男女之间属肉体情欲的爱。
So one is the desire between men and women, this love.、
哦、那这个字眼大家也不会陌生、哦、它的希腊文叫 Eros。
So this is Eros.、
哦、那这个 Eros、哦、台湾话比较传神啦，叫 Eros 啦，爱到 Eros 啦。这台湾人、闽南人才听得懂哈、哦。爱到火冒三丈，爱到冷汗直流，爱到、哦啊、心情很郁闷啊，这种爱、哦、真的是烦死人啊。
So in Taiwanese, that's what happens to sound like a love which can also frustrate
you.、哦、那他讲的是男女之间肉体情欲的爱。
But this is the love between men and women、哦、
那这种爱不是圣经里面神告诉我们的爱。
So this is not the love that the Bible is telling us.、哦、
那第二种爱呢，是讲到亲情之间的爱。
So another type of love is between friends and friendships.、
哦、那么它的这个希腊文叫 philo.
So this is philos.、
哦、叫 philio. 那我们常说、啊、爱得很费力哦。
So in Chinese,、
哦、你看、哦、父母亲对待小孩子爱得很费力哦。啰嗦，不要再讲了啦，讨厌、啊、甩菜甩门。爱他，可是他又了解不了。
So in Chinese, this Hebrew word sounds like it's a love, but it takes a lot of effort, just like how parents can also get very tired and sick of their children.
那第三种爱的形态、哦、就是我们现在所看到的叫 agape。agape 我们去想叫爱加倍了、哦、
So then there's agape.、
哦、那么他讲的是圣爱，是神跟人之间的一种没有条件的爱。
So this is an unconditional holy love that God has for us.
所以我们在解读说，哎，我们的神说你们要彼此相爱。
So God tells us to love one another.
哦，那这个爱哈、哦，不是 L A， 不是 L O S， 不是 Philio 哈、哦，不是这种爱。
So it's not Eros or Philos.
哦，他讲的是神愿意为我们牺牲生命所给我们的那一种爱，你们用这种爱彼此互相去对待。
But God's telling us to love one another with the love that He shows us.
好，那我们必须要从圣经的前后文来看他的意思啦，除了用原文的角度去了解之外。
So other than looking at the original text, we have to also see this in context.
好，所以你现在来看哈，我们来看他的前文，就是彼得前书四章第六节。
So in 1 Peter chapter 4 verse 6.
好，这个彼得前书四章第六节他讲的是什么呢？
So what's recorded in verse 6?
我简单揭露他的焦点，叫传福音。
So summary to preach.
好，那我把原文的解释念给大家当参考。
So for reference, I'll read the explanation from the original text.
说为着将来的审判的缘故。
So for the sake of the judgment in the future.
已经死了的信徒。
Those unbelievers who have died.
当他们还活着的时候，就有福音传给他们。
While they are still alive, gospel was preached to them.
那让他们呢有悔改得救的机会。
So then they have an opportunity to repent and be saved.
那要叫这些人的肉身还是按照所有人类该受的审判进入死亡。
So with their flesh, they'll still be judged and enter into death.
但是他们里面的灵性却能够靠神重新活过来，以致得救。
But the spirit inside them through God will be revived and be alive.
那这个是四章六节它原文的解释。
So this is what the original text explains in verse 6.
因为耶稣基督来到世上为我们牺牲了他的生命。
For Jesus came into this world and sacrificed his life for us.
我们这个肉体还是要进入死亡里面的。
Even so, our fleshly body will still enter into death.
但是我们的灵性却可以因为耶稣基督为我们钉十字架所给我们的赦罪的保险，
But our spiritual life, we have the precious blood of Jesus.
那我们的灵性就能够重新活过来了。
And then our spiritual self can be revived again.
好，我们现在来看马太福音哈。
Let's turn to Matthew.
对不起哈，约翰福音十五章。
Sorry, John chapter 15.
在约翰福音十五章从第九节到这个十四节的这一段经文。
From verse 9 to 14.
你看这段经文里面提到多少爱这个字眼。
So the word love is mentioned multiple times.
第九节，我爱你们。
Verse 9.
正如父爱我。
As the Father loved me, I also love you.
你们要常在我的爱里，就出现了三个爱。
And abide in my love happened three times.
第十节，一直到，那这一段经文所出现的爱，你去看它的英文，全部都叫做 agape， 都是爱加倍。
So all the love.
圣爱。
All the love mentioned here, agape, the holy love.
好，那十三节是一个重点。
And verse 13 is the main point.
耶稣说，人为朋友舍命，人的爱哦，不会比这个更大。
So a greater love has no one than this.
好，那耶稣基督他亲自为我们舍命了。
So Jesus himself gave up his life for us.
我们电脑再做一下，约翰一书三章十六节。
So in 1 John chapter 3, verse 12.
神说，当天上这位神来到世上为我们舍命的时候，我们才能够知道什么叫做爱。
When our Heavenly Father came down on earth, that's how we learn love.
所以耶稣基督为我们钉死十字架。
So Jesus crucified on the cross.
他流出的宝血。
The precious blood he shed.
他要洁净我们的罪。
This will wash away our sins.
那这个是神的命定，赦罪的唯一的一个管道了哈，洗礼哈，借着耶稣的宝血，唯一的一个管道。
And this was set by God, and the only way that baptism can be done.
在希伯来书第九章的二十二节。
So in Hebrews chapter 9 verse 22.
这个是神的方法，不是人的方法。
So this is the method of God, not method of man.
说如果没有流血的话哈，没有人的罪能够得到赦免了。
If no blood is shed, then no one's sins can be washed away.
那耶稣基督既然为我们钉死十字架，然后把这个圣爱没有条件的加注在每一个人的身上，我们的神愿意这样做。
And since God is willing to come down in flesh as Jesus and die for us and use this blood for us,
所以我们的神说，你们就是用这样子的我牺牲生命、流出宝血、无条件爱你们的这一种爱，彼此互相对待。
This is the type of sacrificial love that God wants us to treat each other with.
怎么样能够达到这个境界？
So how can we reach this?
不是说你有困难，我给你两百块啊，你有需要，我送一条棉被给你哈。So, 这个达不到圣爱的阶段。
So this is not just you need some help. Here's $200 and a blanket.
唯有传福音才能够把耶稣基督所给我们的这种爱传递出去。
Only through preaching the gospel can we preach this love of Jesus to others.
我强调的是彼此相爱，第一个角度就是请大家一定要记得，末世的时代在使命的认知上最重要的是什么？是传福音。
That's why when it says to love one another, one action that we have to do is actually to preach to others.
当有罪人接受耶稣基督的福音，愿意进入耶稣基督宝血的赦罪里面，
When a sinner is willing to come to Jesus and be washed clean through his precious blood,
那么他的爱就全部得到神的赦免了，遮掩许许多多的罪了，这个罪就不复存在了。
Then his sins will be completely washed away, won't be there anymore.
所以保罗哈，他有一个很好的观念呐，在传福音的工作上。
So Paul, he has the right attitude, when he's preaching.
我们谈到说哈，你看耶稣基督为我们舍命，保罗为了传福音，他说我的命也可以不要哦。
So Jesus gave up his life for us, but when Paul is preaching, he's saying that for the sake of preaching, he's willing to give up his life.
他这个传福音的程式达到跟耶稣基督一样的。
So the way he's preaching is like how Jesus preached.
我们根据的经文是罗马书第九章的第一节到第三节。
So Romans chapter 9, verse 1 to 6.
保罗他说哈，如果我的骨肉之亲啊，如果我的兄弟哈能够得救哈，我被咒诅跟基督分离都无所谓。
So here Paul is saying that for the sake of people to believe, he's willing to be cursed or be separated from Christ.
那换句话说哈，保罗他这个爱已经提升到耶稣基督那样子的层次了。
So see that Paul's love is elevated to the love that Jesus had.
我愿意牺牲我的生命，只要你们能够得到神的爱。
I'm willing to give up my life as long as you can receive the love from Christ.
所以在罗马书第一章的十三节。
So in Romans chapter 1 verse 13.
以下哈，保罗说哈，什么人我都有一个生活的观念，就是我欠债，我欠他们很多很多。我是债务人啊，我不是债权人啊。
So Paul sees that himself as a someone who owns people debt.
外邦人才是债权人啊。好，如果以得救传福音这件事情来讲，我们这些真耶稣教的信徒，我们是债务人啊，我们是负债的啦，欠他们很多啦。
So we have to think of it as for the non-believers, we actually own them something. We own them, and that's why we're in debt.
我们可不可以因为耶稣基督的死？让耶稣基督的活在我们身上，然后我们把这样子的活的机会得到神的爱，然后也传递到别人身上。
So we can be alive again because of Jesus Christ, and in the same way, we have to pass this on to other people who is yet to believe.
大家有没有听过哈、那个跳楼压死卖肉粽的？
So have you heard the story about someone who jumped off a building?
我不晓得我们这个国家有没有这种情形啊？哈。
But then end up squishing someone down there.
台湾第一件哈、跳楼啊、它发生的时间是，我查一下哈、对不起哈、它发生的时间是1986年。
So in 1986, this is when there was an incident in Taiwan.
那么这个小姐哈、她叫胡玉梅。
So there was this Miss Lee.
她住在台北市新生北路二段。
So she lived in Taipei.
她的感情受到挫折。
And because she had some relationship problems,
所以她想不开。
So she was feeling quite bad.
所以在3月5号 ,1986 年3月5号凌晨3点爬到他们家那栋大楼的第13楼。
So on the 3 a.m. in March that year, she climbed up to the 13th floor.
她跳楼自杀。
And she jumped, she threw herself off the
building. 不是很不幸的是哈、有一个清苦的家庭、这个男主人叫黄栋梁。
And there was a Mr. Huang downstairs.
他白天工作、家里面有三个孩子、还有太太、他必须要抚养。
And so he already has a day job, but he has three kids and wants to sustain his family.
所以他的太太就催肉粽，然后他这个黄先生下班休息一下，晚上九点十点以后就用脚踏车推着这个肉粽啊，然后沿街叫卖啊，
And so,
小巴桑哦，小巴桑哦，烧肉粽啊，烧肉粽啊，听说买的人还相当多了
哈。So he was making some extra income by selling these rice dumplings the wife will make.
怎么那么恰巧，这个胡小姐跳楼下来啊，刚好卖肉粽的脚踏车也到一下来，刚好跌在她身上啊，把这个卖肉粽的黄先生压死掉了。
So unfortunately, when this lady threw herself off the building, she landed on him who was trying to make a living.
然后呢，这个胡小姐哈、轻伤了。
But then this Miss Hu, she was only lightly injured.
那这个是台湾第一起这个跳楼自杀压死底下的行人呐、压死卖肉粽的。
So this is what happens when someone tried to commit suicide, but end up killing someone underneath.
那这个时候呢，因为是第一个发生的案例嘛，我们的司法界有很多的讨论，台湾的社会有很多的讨论。
And because this was the first time such incident happened, so there was a lot of discussion in Taiwan.
比如说我查到的资料，他从这个文学的文化背景的角度去做讨论。
So some people looked at this from a literary perspective.
那么有从心理学的角度去做剖析。
Or some people looked at this from a psychology perspective.
那么教育单位也从教育的角度，怎么样去防备这些自杀的事件。
And so education departments also looked at how to prevent such incidents from happening.
那当然法律界有他们法的一个什么，一个思考的原则。
So obviously the legal system will have its way to deal with this truth.
那宗教界呢也提出了他们的建议的看法。
And religious societies also provided their input.
所以在当时的佛教哈，佛教他们用因缘的结果论，他们也提出了一篇给政府参考的一个什么一个因素，一个讲论文，应该不是论，一个参考的文章。
So for the Buddhists, they also wrote an article and passed it to the government for extra insight.
那基督教呢？ 也用基督教的名义提出了一篇给政府参考的文章，怎么样去解决这件事呢？
And likewise, for the Christian community, and also an article was passed to the government.
所以我现在揭露重点哈，基督教跟政府建议。
So for the Christians, they suggested.
他说这个人跳下来，本来这个人是该死的，因为他不想活嘛，哈。
So the person committing suicide, they are supposed to die because they do not want to live.
这个卖肉粽的黄先生是冤枉死的，被压死的，无妄之灾。
But Mr. Huang, he was innocent. It was a bad accident for him.
你现在把这一个浮消息说啊，过失杀人啊，你要用什么法律？你要判他的刑罚啊，关几年？
So for the person committing suicide, if you judge them and say that because you killed someone, you need to be put in jail.
这个对黄先生他们的家庭一点帮助都没有。
This doesn't actually help Mr. Huang and his family at all.
所以宗教界基督教宗教界的建议，他们引证一段经文。
So the Christian community based this on the verse.
他说我们建议这个胡小姐她的刑罚应当可以这样做思考了。
And suggested perhaps the punishment for the person committing suicide should be this.
就请胡小姐到外面去认真努力殷勤工作赚钱来抚养黄先生他们这个家庭。等到这三个孩子全部都长大成人，经济已经独立了，她的刑罚就咔结束。
For Ms. Huang, she should go and work and support the family of Mr. Huang that she killed until the three kids are old enough to be financially independent.
那他们引证哪一段经文呢？基督教界。
So which verse was this based on?
在哥林多后书第五章的十五节。
Second Corinthians chapter 5, verse 15.
他引证耶稣基督啊，他一个人死是为众人死。
How Jesus died for all.
哥林多后书五章十五节。
Second Corinthians chapter 5 verse 15。
所以圣经说那我们这些活着的人呢，不要再为自己活了。
So those who are still alive do not live for themselves。
那我们应当为那替我们而死的那一位主来活。
Instead, we should live for the Lord who has died for us.
所以胡小姐，你要代替黄先生活着，然后抚养他们这个家庭，让他们能够得到建立。
So Ms. Hu should work hard and help Mr. Huang's family until they are established.
因为你欠债。
Since you own them.
你欠黄先生他们这一家人太多债。
You own them a lot of debt.
那既然你还活着，你用你的命来偿债。
And since you're still alive, then you use what's left of your life to repay this debt.
我个人认为这个建议真的很好啊。没有比这个更好的判决了。
So for me, I thought that this is a great way to deal with this situation.
那可惜我们当时的这个法律界，台湾的法律界是没有接受了。
But unfortunately, the legal system didn't use this method.
那我现在这样思考。
So now I'm pondering.
今天耶稣基督为了我们的罪被钉死在十字架上。
Today Jesus for our sins was crucified on the cross.
然后让我们的灵性能够因着耶稣基督活起来，得到一个新生的生命。
And our spiritual life can be renewed because of him.
那我们可不可以用神所赏赐给我们这个新生的生命，我们来偿债？好像保罗说，什么人我都欠债。
So can we now use our old life, use our new life, and recognize that we owe people debt?
那甚至他愿意他愿意把他的生命付上，让耶稣基督的爱能够提升在我们的生活里面。
So for Paul, he's willing to even give up his life to express and show this love of Jesus.
那我认为这个才是我们现在所在分享的耶稣说彼此相爱，遮掩许多的罪。
So this is, I think, what it means when Jesus says that love one another because it covers up a multitude of sins.
而且我们一个真耶稣教的信徒我们不要徒受神的恩典。
And so as a member of TJC, we shouldn't hog the grace of God.
因为这本圣经我们的神说，当我给你生命救恩的时候，那当然以我们来讲，这个是恩典白白得到的恩典。
So we know that we all freely received this grace from God.
当我们得到生命救恩的同时同步同步。
At the same time, at the time where we receive this grace from God.
我们天上的神他就把传福音的使命也加注在得到救恩的人的身上。
at the same time entrust to us this mission of gospel preaching to those who he has bestowed grace.
2 Corinthians chapter 5.
2 Corinthians chapter 5.
18-19.
Verse 18-19.
所以18节他说, 感谢他, 借着耶稣基督, 我们与神和好了, 这个就是生命的救恩。
So we receive this reconciliation towards God.
但是接下来是什么? 是同步完成的, 它是平行句, 原文是平行句, 没有先后的问题的, 是同步完成的, 圣经说什么? 说, 将劝人与神和好的职分也放在我们的身上。
And happens in parallel at the same time that he has given us the ministry of reconciliation.
所以19节重复再讲一次，用不同的字眼。
And then verse 19, this is repeated.
所以我们一个真耶稣教的信徒，我觉得我们不要徒受神的恩典。
So as a member of TJC, we shouldn't simply take the grace of God and don't spread it.
彼此相爱最好的一个方向就是传福音。
Because the best way to love one another is actually to go preach.
让所有的这些罪人也能够跟我们一样进入到神没有条件的爱里面。
So that other sinners can also come together with us, enjoy the love of Jesus that has no boundaries.
那透过耶稣基督宝血的洗礼，他的罪就得到了遮掩，不复存在。
And Jesus' blood will also wash away their sins.
这是第一个角度。
So this is from the first aspect.
我现在讲彼此相爱的第二个角度。
And now the second aspect of loving one another.
在我们工作的使命上，我们除了传福音之外， 因为这样子能够把基督的爱显明出来。
So other than showing the love of Jesus through preaching,
那么第二个角度在哪里呢？
What's the second part?
我们来看雅各书第五章。
James chapter 5.
雅各书第五章的19节跟20节
Verse 19 and 20
叫寻回软弱迷失的羊 神的羊
We have to seek out the Lamb of God who are weak
所以这段经文 我们的神透过雅各 那么做的这样子的一个这个彼此相爱的一个方向的指导
So through James, God is telling us how to love one another.
他说，在我们的行列当中，如果有人在正道上已经迷失了，很多软弱存在了，很多我们的理由了，因为人、因为环境、因为个人的软弱，因为我经济上的需要，很多人迷失掉了。
So some people might have gone astray. It can be many reasons because of people, because of finances.
我们常常讲说，我们教会应该有130个啦，但安息日会来聚会的大概八九十个啦，那剩下的40-50个人在哪里？So
often we might hear that while this church has 130 people, but during Sabbath there's only 80, so there's several many people missing.
在正耶稣教会的每一间地方教会都是这样子的情况，台湾也不例外。
And this is the situation in all TJC churches.
那主耶稣说，哎呀，有人在正道上已经走错了，迷失掉了。
So Jesus also said that, regards to truth, some people have gone astray.
那么，也许他要去做了一些跟罪相关的不好的行为了。
Perhaps they are doing something that's related to sin.
那我们能不能够去把他挽救回来呢？
And can we still go and save them?
他说，如果让他从迷路上转回，就是救一个灵魂不死，然后再来呢？我们的神说，能够遮掩许多的罪。
And that's why this is all related to if we can bring someone back, then we save a soul and cover up their sins.
如果说我们真耶稣教会的信徒，那么他接受过洗礼之后，他要去换的所谓的立即性。 自死的罪。So
if a TJC believer and goes and do a deadly sin.
那当然，按照圣经的真理，我们就不再为他祷告。Then
according to the Bible, we no longer pray for them.
那如果这个经文是在约翰一书的第五章，So
this is in 1 John chapter 5.
约翰一书第五章的16节，Verse 16.
说如果有兄弟姐妹，他们所犯的是致死的罪，就是说。
这个罪一犯，他的灵命就进入死亡。我们在台湾界定叫犯了立即性致死的罪，就是没有悔改机会的罪，我们就不再为他祷告。So
these are the sins that once you do them, there's no way for you to turn back. So these are deadly sins.
那么在我们台湾总会，我们界定4种罪是立即性致死的罪。So
in Taiwan GA, there's 4 things you can do which will result in this.
一个是拜偶像。
worshiping idols.
第二戒。
That's the second commandment.
一个是第七戒叫犯奸淫。
Seventh commandment, which is adultery.
那么一个是第六戒叫杀人。
And the sixth commandment, murder.
那当然我们不会杀人，不会无缘无故杀人，但是我们要强调的是，请你不要堕胎。堕胎也是杀人。
So we won't go and kill someone, but we have to take note that abortion we cannot do.
那也不要自杀，因为自杀也是杀人，杀自己不会得救的。
And likewise with suicide, you are killing yourself, so then you can't be safe.
那第四种就是你接受了真耶稣教会的洗礼，领受了耶稣基督的圣餐之后，我离开了这间唯一得救的教会，那么又去接受其他教派的洗礼，领他们的圣餐，这个也是立即性自赎的罪。
And then the fourth one is that if you have if you're a member, receive Holy Communion in our church, but then go to another denomination, get baptized, and also partake in the Holy Communion.
那如果我们迷失的羊数犯了这四种罪，那我们就不再为他祷告了，不积极寻找了。他要回来，我们还是接纳了，因为有悔改中比没有悔改好啊。
So these four things, if people do them, then we won't pray for them and ask them to come back. But obviously, if they want to come back voluntarily, then we're happy for them to return.
但如果失迷真道的他没有犯这些立即性自赎的罪，他所犯的罪是有悔改机会的。
But for the people that have not committed these deadly sins, and they can have a chance to repent and return.
我们还是要把他挽救回来啊，多多探访他，帮助他祷告，跟他沟通当朋友，把他领回来神的真道上面。
Then we have to do all we can to bring them back to the truth of God.
因为他主要跪在神的面前，愿意向神认罪悔改。
So because if they are willing to return to God, kneel and repent to God.
那么耶稣基督宝血的赦罪性继续在他的身上，可以运行洗净他所犯的罪。
Then Jesus' blood can, which continually cleanses us, will be able to wash away his sins.
那我们的根据是约翰一书第一章。
So this is from 1 John chapter 1.
第八节跟第九节。
Verse 8 to 9.
洗礼不是说洗礼那一次耶稣基督的宝血才有赦罪的功效性，不是只有这样。
So during baptism, it's not just that.At that point in time, Jesus' blood is effective.
而是当接受过了我们身上有耶稣基督的宝血之后，我们犯了不至于死的罪，这个认罪悔改的时候，这个宝血洁净的功效持续会在我们身上发生。
But if we do not commit deadly sins, then the efficacy of Jesus' blood washing us clean still happens.
所以在第九节提到说神是信实的，是公义的，我们若认自己的罪，那么他要赦免我们的罪，再来呢，洗净我们一切的不义。这个洗净你去看，它是现在进行式，永远都在进行的。
So in verse 9, how the washing will actually, is actually a continuous action.
只要我们愿意认罪悔改，我们的神就愿意赦免我们所犯的罪。
So as long as we are willing to repent, then God is willing to forgive us.
我们能够重新在神面前站起来，然后呢，罪得到宝血的洁净，但是你要立住，我不再犯同样的过错了。
Then,
不要说一直犯一直犯，每次犯就来悔改，每次犯就来悔改，那这个也是没有用的啦。
And then we have to resolve not to sin again. We can't just continually do this.
那这样也能够遮掩许多的罪。
So through all this, multitude of sins can be covered.
所以我觉得圣经里面也有一个人物他也是为了要挽回百姓，他到耶和华神面前为百姓恳求，甚至把他的命都赌上。
So there is also a Bible character who's willing to pray for others and even offer up their life.
我们来看出埃及记三十二章，这个人叫摩西。
Exodus 32, he is Moses.
出埃及记三十二章三十二节。
Exodus 32, verse 32.
百姓在西乃山下拜金牛犊，这个圣经说上面犯了大罪。
So the people worship the golden calf and committed this great sin.
三十节摩西对百姓说你们犯了大罪。
Verse 30, Moses said that you have committed a great sin.
三十一节摩西到耶和华神面前也跟想说百姓犯的是大罪。
Verse 31, Moses before the Lord said that these people have committed a great sin.
他说神啊倘若你肯赦免他们的罪。
So then he says that if you will forgive their sin.
那再来圣经是什么点点点，就是说他找不到理由。不知道用什么样的角度 拜托神赦免百姓的罪。
Then there's a pause there, meaning that he doesn't know for what reason God might want to do this.
这个是圣经里面唯一祷告不下去的祷告。
So this is a prayer that got left halfway.
所以你看摩西，他就把他的生命献上来了。神啊，这样你不赦免百姓，我就跟百姓下地狱。生命册，把我除名。
Then Moses continues saying that, but if not, I pray, blot me out from the book.
所以保罗为了传福音，他愿意舍命。
So for Paul, for the sake of preaching, he's willing to offer up his life.
摩西为了百姓所犯的罪，要挽救他们回到神面前，他也愿意舍命。
Moses, for the sake of getting God to forgive the people, he's willing to offer up his life.
那这个都是圣爱，没有条件的。
So both of these are holy love.
所以我们真耶稣教会在一个末日的时代，我们的使命的两大方向。
So for True Jesus Church, for our mission in the end times,
传福音。
We need to preach.
一个就是挽回迷失的羊。
And also call back the lost
lamb. 所以路加福音十五章，你看那个迷失的羊，本来是百分之一啊，一百只羊失落的一只啊，再来是十分之一啊，十块钱掉了一块钱啊，到最后耶稣讲什么？浪子的比喻，二分之一，那个比例越来越重。
So in Luke 15, the parables going from one missing lamb out of 100 to $1 out of 10, and then the lost son, so this is one out of two sons.
所以在末日临近的时候，我们要能够记住神给我们的这三个很重要的信仰生活的方向。
And so we know to know that in the end times, there are these things we need to take note of.
在物质的生活上，我们要能够自我节制。
First, in material things, we need to have self-control.
要把生命都全部投注在这个物质的获得，丧失了我们灵魂得救的盼望。
We shouldn't put all our focus on material things and forget about our spiritual life.
我们在灵性上要警醒祷告，免得我们进入到罪的迷惑里面。
Second, we have to be watchful and pray lest we are being deceived.
那丧失了我们得救的盼望。
And lose the hope of salvation.
我们在圣公使命上，我们传福音，挽救迷失的羊，这个都是神对我们的吩咐。
And thirdly, God has given us a mission to preach and call back the missing lambs.
求主耶稣来祝福我们。
May God bless us.
一起来唱赞美诗，509首。
Let's sing hymn 509.